And we're laying down the law. And the Spurs, they got five.
Yep.
Five rings.
Got five on
five
it.
Five rings. Go ahead.
Got five on it. Yeah, so the Spurs definitely got five on it. And I'm talking earlier about Summer League, drop one. But, you know, the Summer League, good development. Get to get the good early looks and see what's going on with the program. And then, you know, talking about basketball, a lot of the craziness in the free agency. The one thing that's interesting, though, is you look at Gasol makes a move, LeBron makes a move, but the Spurs, business as usual.
True, but they do make some moves. You may not see the move.
Well, what I'm talking about is, you know, it's very business as usual in the sense of we keep that steady flow.
Right.
Keep the steady flow.
And not to be greedy, but we could have had more than five.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You know, nothing wrong with five.
Oh, no. No, no. So, possibly based on the foundation that's there, and now with the development of some different things from a coaching perspective, I think that we may be able to really, 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 really make a strong run for full six.
Well, keep that in your back pocket.
Mm-hmm.
The Midsummer's Night Classic took place last weekend with the All-Star Game. We had a chance to talk a little bit with Reed Ryan, president of Houston Astros. So I thought it'd be only fair if we get some information. And it's a surprise because I think prior to the season, maybe this is a Dallas thing up in that metro area. With the lineup, you would have thought the Texas Rangers and everything would have been just, you know, full bore.
Mm-hmm.
That's not the case. So what we want to do, though, and we kind of encompass, because then now they've had some injuries and they've had to draw on their AAA team and do some things like that. We bring in the voice of the AAA affiliate of the Texas Rangers, the Round Rock Express's own, and a fan of the show, a friend of the show, Mike Capps. Mike, good morning, and welcome back to Laying
Okay, I'll
along.
Send you a check for the intro.
Hey, listen, when I get a good intro, I humbly appreciate it and write the check, too.
Oh,
so,
it's my pleasure.
How you doing?
I'm just great. It's this. Awesome being me. quote Crocodile Dundee.
No doubt. A lot of folks leaving the North Austin area in kind of droves because of the injuries to the big ball club up in Arlington.
Kind of a few. Let's put it in perspective. We have made 147 transactions this season.
Wow.
Okay. And we still have 6 weeks left to go in the season. So we're going to be, we're going to be pushing 200 transactions.
What's a normal season? To give
100 to 125.
Wow.
So, and here's the deal about it. I mean, it starts with the injuries. Of course, because at one point, I think they had 27 guys on the DL, which is just unheard of.
Right.
So that makes me think that in the offseason, the Rangers are going to be reevaluating just a whole lot of things, including the way they train players physically and get them ready for the season. I mean, 27 on the DL, I mean, that's just highly unusual. Now, you can't keep Derek Holland from falling down the steps in his house, chasing his dog, or whatever the story was.
Yeah, they tell him to buy a ranch-style house. He don't have no steps.
Well,
I know, it's America. You can buy whatever you want.
But long story short, I just think they're going to have to do some reevaluating on how they train these guys up. And that's just so unusual. I mean, you're going to have injuries. I mean, you know about professional athletics as well as anybody, and people are going to get hurt. They just are. And just the day and day wear and tear will cause some strength problems to come up, and then you have muscle injuries and away you go. But this has just been so unusual. And I've always said, and you've heard me say this, the AAA level is the most difficult to win at just by itself, let alone when you start to factor in the injuries, because the roster is so transient and changing all the time. And, of course, you know, we've not had, I can't recall, five straight days that we've had the same lineup in order. I mean, it just hasn't happened this year.
Yeah.
And I just think Steve Buschel and Spike Owen and Brad Holman and Justin Mayshore have done a great job keeping this thing afloat and keeping us as close to 500 as we've been just because of all the player moves. It's just been crazy.
Yes, absolutely. And I've not seen anything like it. I didn't know that y'all had easily exceeded what is normal in a calendar and a season for a year. But every time you get an update, something is going on with the Texas Rangers and, you know, effectively the Round Rock Express and the AAA affiliate.
Besides, well, Alex Leos went down yesterday
right.
with a leg injury.
Yeah.
I mean, so, and I haven't seen that we've made a move. I don't know who the heck. Well, we got a couple of outfielders we could send up there, but I mean, Falls, I'm 63 years old. I can still run well, but I can't run a 6'4", 60 anymore. But I guess I could volunteer, huh?
Well, I could go up there. Remember, I had a blast trying out for the Rangers myself.
That's right.
That's right. You know.
Okay, well, I'll have a chat. Buschel's back tomorrow. I'll have a chat.
Let him know. I could do some spot duty. The best thing about baseball.
That would be interesting.
Well, hey.
You know what? It would. And personally, even if I wasn't calling the game, Jeff, I'd pay to see it.
I would too, and I would expect to get in free, but that one I'd pay for.
Hey, listen. Hey, Mike, and we're talking with Mike Capps, the voice of the Round Rock Express, the AAA affiliate of the Texas Rangers. In fact, there's going to be an early game, so we're actually going to end at 11:30, so that we allow that pregame for the Texas Rangers. Sitting in today, and he's always riding with us, Mike, is the lieutenant governor for the South Texas District of the AAU, Rod Chico Tanner. Actually, our man Jeff Blake is vacationing over in the Dominican. He's been very
well. My apologies.
However,
yeah, poor him.
No, exactly.
Yeah, that too.
You know, maybe he could find a couple players over the Dominican and make it a business trip for the Rangers in the Express, where it is. Tremendous baseball players from the Dominican Republic.
Oh, yeah.
But I would certainly give you a few games, no doubt, if needed, if necessary. At least if nothing else, I can come to Round Rock and let those guys go up to Arlington.
I knew you had an angle on it.
Hey, he always has an angle. What are you talking about? and you've known him maybe longer than I have. So,
exactly.
You know, it's amazing. You come on the show, you might as well get ready. You might as well wear your flak jacket and your asbestos pants because you're going to get lit up.
And some boots. It's right? Some boots up to your knee, at least.
Get your Kevlar out.
Let me ask you this, too. You talk injuries, and I know it's a different farm system, but the Astros failed to sign their number one pick because of being able not being able to pass the physical. Tell us the process so they go back into the draft. That's a lot different, I think, than what most people know about the NFL draft and the NBA draft and things like that.
Well, it's crazy different, but I think without belaboring a point, I think they need to make some kind of an adjustment because, first of all, the way it works is you lay out verbally an agreement, and before you sign, you have a physical. Well, wait a minute. These kids have been scouted. If you're a high school senior, you've been scouted since you were a sophomore, okay? And teams know about you. They know about your history, your injury history. They know who your parents are. They know about your character. But, I mean, you're going to lay out – I mean, just – tell me what's wrong about this picture. You're going to lay out $6.7 million for an unproven high school left-hander, and you're not going to do MRIs and all sorts of big-time physical tests on him before you even sit down and talk money. I mean, that's just I just find it incomprehensible that Major League Baseball is that archaic in the way it goes about this process. This is the entry level process to the game, just like the NFL draft, just like the NBA draft. I mean, you're talking about scans of millions of dollars for unproven people.
Well, yeah, and Mike, I'm shocked. I'm shocked that you're telling us that they have no physical. I mean, when you go to the combine, and I wish Jeff was here because he's been checked, rechecked, tested, and retested times over before they.
The way I understand it is that they begin to talk money. There's no contract signed until the physical is done. To me. Now, you got to understand the rote numbers of the kids that they bring in via the draft process is much higher than the NFL or the NBA.
Right.
And I understand that. But I'm talking about kids you know that are going to go through your top three rounds or top five rounds. You got to be tip-top on top of their meds before you even talk money.
Right.
Or contract or anything like that. I mean – And I'm not so sure, and I'm certainly not an insider with the Astros on this. They didn't lose just the one draft pick. They lost three draft picks out of this that they're not going to get back. I mean, they lost two other high school pitchers in the top five rounds simply because the way the money was dispersed, and it's a complicated formula. But it's like, wait a second, this has got to change. This has got to change. And I'm not blaming Jeff Luhnow or anybody with the Astros, although it seems to me that if you're going to lay that kind of money out, you got to know what's going on.
Right. Right. My parents wouldn't give me $20 unless they knew when, where, how, and when I was going to be back. And
that's because parents have changed since you and I grew up. They have. That's just the way it is.
Well, I tell you, that is a shocker, and I would. We may have to do a little more on the MLB draft and how that takes place.
I think that's a great whole show for you, Foss. Really.
Well,
I agree.
It's unbelievable.
It's just listening right now is a heck of an education for me. You know,
I had no idea.
I didn't either, and I'm not a big baseball fan. I'm not. My brother is. My brother's huge, and you know, but. But still, I had no idea it operated like that.
Well, yeah,
you know, I guess I sort of, in the back of my mind knew. But when you're talking about, I guess it took something like this to hit me right square in the mouth with it. Because I, when I saw that and read it, I thought, whoa! What are you talking about? But apparently, that's the way it works. I've read and reread this to the point where I'm going like, okay, look. I understand baseball doesn't market its players nearly as well as basketball and football does. They just don't. But, I mean, you got to be on top of stuff like this. I mean, I'm stunned by it, to say the least.
Yeah, yeah. We're talking with Mike Capps, the voice of the Round Rock Express, the AAA affiliate of the Texas Rangers. So how do the Rangers get back on track?
Well, they got to get well. I mean, it's as simplistic as that sounds. That's going to be what has to happen. And some of these young players they're counting on, instead of flipping them from the double A level right into the big leagues without some triple A seasoning, I think is a bit of a mistake because most of the kids by the time they get to double A have really never failed. And so you get them against these old dogs in triple A. And who can teach them tricks, and they struggle, and they scuffle. And, Foss, you've seen it in games. You know this happens. At the end of the day, the bad news is you send them to the big leagues, and they fail, and then you have all this mental angst going on that you got to overcome from young kids who are in their early 20s, and sometimes they get back on track, and sometimes they don't. And that's a function of your philosophy at the major league level more than anything else. But, again, gosh, they got a lot of talent. I mean, we ran a couple of relief pitchers out last night that were spectacular. There's a kid that nobody's heard of named Phil Klein. He's 6'7 and 260, and he tops out at 95 miles an hour with a fastball. But what he does, he's coming from so high, his long arms, and the ball comes down so viciously and so rapidly, it's like he's throwing a sinker with his fastball. He broke two bats, the first two hitters, and pitched two perfect innings and against a team that we've had trouble keeping off the boards. Iowa Cubs can swing it. They've got a couple of guys that are going to be big-time major league home run hitters, and Javi Baez and Chris Bryant. And those guys couldn't handle him. So they've got talent in the pipeline coming. But my deal is, come on, let them season out a little bit. Let them grow up at this level, because the AAA level is banging on the door of big league level, and there's some old dogs in there, and Foss, you've seen them play.
Yes.
Who can really turn you around if you're a youngster and you're too adrenaline charged. It's such a game of failure anyway, and you want them to fail before they get on that big stage.
Absolutely.
And I've actually had the pleasure of going to three Round Rock Express games myself, so I definitely can speak on the level of play.
Yeah. Mike, tell us briefly, because, you know, you've been in baseball for decades, and I'll just leave it at that. That could just be two.
I was in the news business for two decades before I got into baseball, so I'm long in the tooth. But
what about the missions? Just a quick comment. I know you know the Texas League pretty well.
I love their organization. Burl Yarbrough was one of the encouragers that I talked to when I was contemplating getting out of the news business and getting into the baseball business, and they want to run a wonderful organization. I wish, I'm selfish. We had such a great rivalry with San Antonio when we were in the Texas League before we moved to the Pacific Coast League. I'd love to see them move up to AAA ball.
Yes.
And build a AAA ballpark in San Antonio, because I'll guarantee you, you go out there and put a ballpark on the north side of San Antonio, you'd kill it.
I'm selfish.
I'd love to have them back, because San Antonio is such a great city. I love it. I have friends and family there, and it's just a wonderful, wonderful place to go hang. And plus, my buddy Bert Hooten lives there in the off season, the pitching coach.
Oh, that's
the
right.
Padres system.
Yeah.
And so it's a great time anytime my sweetheart and I go down there, because we have family down there, and it's a wonderful, wonderful place. And a couple of gyms I go to, the Olympic Gym out there on the north side of town, and then there's a couple parts I go run and do my sprints in. So we try to stay in shape, Foss.
I'd like to hear what you're talking about that, because, you know, San Antonio, of course, the Spurs are here, and we've teeter-tottered on a couple of other major league sports, trying to get major league soccer here, dabbled in the whole trying to bring an NFL football team here. But I think we probably stand a better chance of, like you said, a AAA ball club here, are getting the missions moved up, and then, like you said, build that 35 rivalry back. I think that's a great thing.
Or let me give you another thing. I need to jump in the shower and head for church, but let me give you just another thought process. What if you went out on that 130 tollway and you were able to lure a major league team to somewhere along the 130 tollway between Austin and San Antonio, and you had rapid transit between the two cities? You think we wouldn't kill it in this area?
There you
I'm
go.
I'm telling you, this is the next. The population in our lifetime, guys, in my opinion, is going to dictate that happen. I mean, just the total population. You think about it. There's like 4.5 million people between Georgetown and South San Antonio now.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, that's a huge area. Yeah, that's a major league area. Yeah. It's already proven with the Spurs.
Absolutely.
But I'm saying somewhere on that tollway, that's a bigger space between Austin and San Antonio than it was between Dallas and Fort Worth.
But it's easier to move, though. Oh, it's easier to move, though. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, yes. I've been on it several times, and, man, it's nice.
Well, Mike, listen.
Yeah, hey. You can drive 90 miles an hour, I'm for it, man.
Oh, absolutely. Well, listen, don't drive 90 miles an hour to church, okay? Because
I live in Northwest Hills. I can't get up to 90 miles an hour going to church. All right, both of you, promise me one thing. Promise me you'll get to Dell Diamond before the season's over.
Oh, yeah. We're gonna pester you in the in your living quarters for the evening or afternoon. Certainly
it
we'll
is where
do
I
that.
Steal money, gentlemen.
Doing what you love. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yes,
and we love what you do, and we appreciate you. Thanks for your time. And we'll have you back before the Major League Baseball season
That's
and
fine.
The Minor League Baseball season is over.
I work cheap.
You and you're a treat to have. Thanks again, Mike right. Capps, the voice okay. of the
Enjoy
Round
it,
Rock
guys.
Express. All right, AAA affiliate of the Texas Rangers. We're going to come back. We're going to talk with more legendary greatness and Hall of Fame basketball coach Pete Carril. We're going to see what the new head man that's going to be driving LeBron around the NBA courts has to say about his pupil when we come back right here on Laying Down the Law.